contribution on Germany. I don't know if you have questions, then I can provide you further details, but you find it on the related web pages. Otherwise, I would continue with UNISEC Europe. So the local chapters, Germany, Lithuania, Samara, Turkey, and possibly soon Italy, are integrated here, and we are trying to accommodate other partners. So what we are targeting here is a joint proposal for space outreach activities in order to run UNISEC. You need funding, and most of the funding for space in Europe is related to European institutions, like the European Space Agency, like the European Union Research Program. And therefore, it's beneficial if you have a European institution to apply there. So we try to cooperate also on the educational level. Most institutions have CANSAT programs, CubeSat programs, and this way it makes sense to organize together CubeSat conferences and to exchange the experiences. So another feature which is very helpful for all of us relates to ground station networks, and I think that's a major task in UNISEC Global anyway. And we try to further promote it inside Europe and to connect, of course, with the worldwide partners. And new activities we addressed concerns the standardization of electrical and software interfaces. And this will be the main part of my talk today, because I think it's very important for exchangeability for corporations. So, typically, the CubeSats are built from components, and it would be helpful to exchange at component level. This would help all the different teams, because the specialization is different at every site. Some are related to payload, some other emphasis is related to onboard data handling or to communication. And if we have joint interfaces, we can much easier exchange between the different teams. And, the success of the CubeSat definition was that it created a standard regarding the dimensions, the 10 by 10 by 10. And this way, you had access to joint launcher adapters. Yeah. The CubeSat standard is not more. It only helps you to get the same adapters. You don't have to reinvent the wheel with respect to accommodation at different rockets. And now it would be very helpful to extend standardization on the component level, on the subsystem level. Then you can, between different teams, you can easily exchange subsystems. And this helps to focus more on their own specialties. And this way, international corporations would be eased dramatically. So you see here standard building blocks, this might assist also in integration. What you see here as example, this is UV3, which was launched in 2013. And the building blocks are relatively simple, and you just plug in a base plate, and within 1 hour, the CubeSat is assembled. So our stay time in the clean rooms is very limited. So the flight model was assembled in the order of some hours. Of course, testing and so on follows, but integration itself is supported. So what we see here, that's PC C104, which is approaching some kind of standard in CubeSats. It's an adaptation from an industrial bus, but it's not compliant with the industrial bus anymore. Yeah, so it's, it must be clearly said. The adaptation is about 30% of sold CubeSats. The different companies, GOM Space ESIS are here on the boot, they have such interfaces available. But we just had 2 weeks ago an industrial day at the European Space Agency, and it turned out nobody is content with the standard. Because as you see here, it's very bulky, so the connectors take a large partition of your CubeSat, and in particular, if you want to go to one unit, two unit CubeSats, this takes a lot of your space. And so the question was how to do it more efficiently, in particular to allow to stay at the very small size, one unit, two unit CubeSats. And so you struggle with volume. So the beneficial aspects should be carried over. There's a lot of room for improvement, and many aspects are not addressed by the PC104 standards, which are essential in space, like power generation. Your solar arrays provide you a huge fluctuation of generated power, and this cannot be anticipated by this bus. Or you have redundancy in your satellite system. That's also not sufficiently addressed here. So this PC104 has a very large footprint, so it takes about 10 to 15% of the overall volume. It's relatively high. And nevertheless, only a small fraction of the 104 pins are used. And those who are used are not really standardized. The different companies allocate different properties to the different pins. Another feature is the stacking principle. So you see here at the assembly, the signals have to pass through all the connectors. So a signal from here to here has to pass the connectors at all the intermediate steps. And this means you lose a lot of performance. It's all the connectors, you have a loss of power. You have an increase of noise in each connector. And that's not very efficient. So the stacking principle is disadvantages in our framework of CubeSats. So a much better established alternative would be a backplane. So one sideboard where all the connectors to the different boards are established, and you have direct connecting lines between the different boards. So the loss of power is avoided this way. So you see there's a lot of room for improvement on this PC104. And it's not really a standard. Nevertheless, different kits offered on the market share few lines which are used in common. So this is the amount of signals which is really standardized. And you see out of the 104 pins, only 8 are really standardized. It's a ridiculous fraction, 8 pins out of 104. So we cannot really call it a standard, I would say. So in addition, you often need extra connectors. So for solar panel inputs, it's not addressed in the standards. the kill switch logics, when you want to disconnect in case of failures, it's not standardized. The whole area of testing, debugging, and programming interfaces are not addressed at all. So despite this bulky 104 pins, people usually add additional pins. So it gets more bulky only to provide all the necessary interfaces. And also on the logical side, synchronization signals for timing and synchronization between subsystems are not addressed at all. So in a first step, a common standard recommendation was established. So by example, for power generation, as it's a large deficit, some recommendations were established, what would be desirable for the special case of satellites, in particular small satellites, and in particular CubeSats. And also specifications with respect to interface implementing, to have include also monitoring, to include protection, yes, like latch ups you frequently have in the context of space, but it was not addressed at all so far. So such items should be addressed at the standardization level already, and also means to isolate data interface connections on the satellite bus. So this was a recommendation list, and then it finally led to an implementation. This UNISEC Europe bus, and you can download the documentation on our web pages. So it's available at uniseceurope.eu, standards and bus system. So you find an allocation of all the different pins, but you find also a standardization of the logical commands. Yeah, so the mechanical connections are standardized, as well as the logic. And you find standardized interfaces for testing purposes, for software uploads during the initial integration phase. The standard is based on a base plate. Here you have the different boards, the subsystem boards you connect on this base plate, and also the pins for side panels and so on are standardized. So it's an extensive document, I think about 10 pages, where you can download all the specifications. And I think it would be very helpful if in our community we adapt this standard, maybe we still modify it. Some bins are still open for future extensions. And this way, we can inside our community much easier exchange specific boards. Yeah, to give you some idea, here's a power distribution system, that's the logic, and that's the implementation with respect to the pins. With respect to pins to the side panels where the solar arrays are hosted and on the main bus. So everything is pointed out there in a lot of detail. So I'm almost coming to the end. We try inside this UNISEC Europe also to promote international missions. Of course, funding is mainly provided from European Union for European Union members. But there are also very often programs of European Union with the Mediterranean, of European Union with the former Soviet Union, with Japan. There's a joint European Union Japanese program. So we can emphasize in this context such collaborative issues. And I think in particular, networks of small satellites are a very interesting field. If this are formations of satellites where you have closer control contact, or if you have just single satellites cooperating in the form of a constellation. This would be added value for all the participating partners. And I think in particular Earth observation, telecommunication would offer interesting added value for such multi-satellite systems. Support in small satellite design, as I said, on the workshops we try to exchange experiences from earlier missions. Another very important feature are the cooperations in networked ground stations, and here our Japanese friend have a very exemplary network of Japanese universities, and this should be further extended and linked. We provide intensive classes on small spacecraft design. So we had classes so far in Tunisia, Russia, US, Turkey, Brazil, China, and we try to support this way by weekly or two-weekly classes, start up of capabilities. Capability building is a very important issue. We offer participation of students in the Space Master program. So it's a very international program. 50% of the students come from outside Europe. Yeah, so you can look up at the web pages, and we want to encourage to have more international participation. But we had already students from here from Japan, from US, Korean students are still missing, Australian students we had already. So, but it's open to all. And the very interesting feature is scholarships are mainly provided for the non-Europeans. The Europeans only receive a small scholarship, but the non-Europeans receive a real good scholarship. And finally, I want to hint on this Pico Nano Satellite Conference. I want to invite you on this and want to pop up here. Würzburg is a nice place. You have many historic sites. There's a UNESCO World Heritage Castle. River, there's a lot of wine growing, so all the hills are connected to this. The conference takes place at the university, and this way it's a very low participation fee. So you have only €50 participation fee, including even the conference banquet. So we have many sponsors, and you can participate at an international conference at low cost. It's also intended this year that proceedings will be published. So selection of paper is only on abstracts, and until 30th of July, your abstract should reach us. Then the conference program is selected, and based on the presentation, selection of papers will be submitted to IAA, which will publish this as a book. So, yeah, based on presentations, we select the papers which will be published. And this way, additional effort which might not be materializing, yeah, is avoided. Who is selected will be published. So with these perspectives, I want to conclude my talk and thank you for your attention.
Any questions about the presentations? UNISEC Germany or UNISEC Europe? No? Okay, thank you.